let the coffee kick in. We're glad you're here this morning. We need to worship God this morning. We need to lift Him up this morning. I don't know if you like me, man. So many events happening this past week that have just saddened my heart. Things that you have heard said here over the last year. When I've come to you and said time and time and time again that there is a persecution on Christians in this nation. I hope you've wakened up. Another mass shooting. Only this one was more defined. A shooter said, if you're a Christian, stand up. And he shot him in the head. In a small, sleepy little town in a community college that no one in this room ever heard of, I don't think. It could come here. Yeah, I know this is not a good way to start the service. You would rather me pump you up and say, yippee! I don't feel yippee today. Now, everybody's going to try to solve the problem they already have. And we're going through the same song and dance. It's the gun, it's the mental health. It is a mental health issue. Come on. But the prince of this world is unleashing a hell on free worship. He's using some of our politicians. He's using Hollywood. He's using kids who were not raised to understand the value of life. He's using whatever he can to bring an attack against the body of Christ. And where's the moral outrage? I don't know. If they'd been a different religion, do you think the outrage would have been greater? Of course it would have been. In our worship this morning, in our praise this morning, we have to pray for the families that have lost loved ones. We have to pray for a community that has been just ripped apart. But here's what I'm absolutely sure of. As one of the fathers of a female student, 18, that was killed, said, this has shaken our lives, but it will not shake our faith.
Amen.
Amen. Wasn't an accident I was talking about stand up. See, you just thought I just came up with a clever title and some sermons. He asked them to do what?
Stand up.
Stand up. There are no accidents. They stood up. And I find myself asking this question, would I have stood up? We'd like to think we would, don't we?
Amen.
But after the first one got shot, I'm not, you know. It's the same thing. It's just life repeating itself over and over. History over and over and over again. So we've stood up, amen? We've said we're going to stand up. We've stood up. Well, this day we're going to talk about running to the battle lines. That's where we're going. Satan can bring it on, but he cannot overcome the body of Christ. He can rattle our faith, but he can't overcome what Jesus has already done.
Amen.
He can speak all he wants to against us, but we are not fallen. We are victorious. Because the body of Christ, as the Word of God says, has overcome the world. Our victory is already secure.
Amen.
I believe with all my my heart that Jesus welcomed those to the kingdom. I believe he was standing right there at the gate when they showed up. And he said, I'm sorry for what happened to you, but welcome to my heaven. There'll be more coming, and you'll be here to greet them. But until that day, we stand. Until that day, we lift up praises to him. Yeah. It will not stop us. We will go forward. So if you're feeling a little down today, if you're feeling a little sad today, if you're introspective today, thinking about, wow, you know, what really matters in life, this is what matters more than anything else. Praising God. Yeah. Nothing else falls into that category. In the middle of the storm, I will praise your name. So that's what we're going to do this morning. And so this morning as we're singing, I don't want you just to sing to us. I don't want you just to make noise, even if it is a joyful noise. This morning, I want you to sing praises to all those who just went to heaven. I want you to lift up your voice in a way that you never have before. I want you to let them know that we stand with them here today. Amen?
Amen.
Let's praise the Lord this morning. Come on, stand.
Holy.
your glory as you sit on your throne on high.
And on that day when my strength is failing, it draws near and my time has come, still my soul will sing your praise.
His voice trembles. Let them be pleasing to you, Lord. And all the church said,